DaVinci Resolve 19, guys. It's still in beta, but I've already had a lot of fun trying out all the new color grading features, because two of the most important new tools or effects are specifically designed for people like you and me, film look lovers. Yeah, and these tools make creating a film look a whole lot easier, faster, and more enjoyable. And the results look amazing. So let's take a closer look at these new features. Here we go. Also available in the free version of DaVinci Resolve, Color Slice is, in my opinion, one of the most interesting new color grading tools. It allows you to adjust colors. So adjust the hue of specific colors, but also make colors more saturated and richer, without affecting the brightness or luminance, which is especially important if you want to create a film look. And that's also how Blackmagic Design describes this tool. But let me show you a few quick examples and you'll see right away what it does. First example. So, I've applied one of DaVinci Resolve's built-in film look LUTs to this footage. This is before and this is after, and it looks okay, right? But in my opinion, it's missing some of those rich, dense colors of film. And that's exactly what Color Slice does. At the top here, these settings, when adjusted, will affect the whole image. I mean, actually no. When using density, it actually only affects the more saturated areas of the image. See how it only affects the more saturated areas, like that red stripe on the ship and the skin tones. And this is saturation. And the interesting part here is that it doesn't or almost doesn't affect the brightness of the colors. Look, this is the difference between using saturation in the color wheels tab and saturation in the color slice tab. Both are at max saturation. Significant difference, right? And then density depth controls the effect of density adjustments on brighter areas of the image. Saturation depth does the same, but for saturation. And then saturation balance, I have to read this. Saturation balance adjusts how the saturation changes affect the luminance balance in colors with medium saturation levels. So I think I kinda understand what it does, but not 100%. So if any of you can explain that in simple, plain language, drop it in the comments and I will pin that comment. Because yeah, I kinda understand and I see that it does something, but it's not 100% clear. So, you know, drop it in the comments. And then the bottom part is where it gets interesting, because that's where we can tweak specific colors. But instead of having 6 wheels, we have 7. There's also a skin tone wheel. So that gives us an easy way to also adjust the skin tones of an image. See? Hue, density, saturation. And it does it in a way that always looks natural. If you don't overdo it, of course. So, you know, don't overdo it. So Color Slice allows you to get those rich, dense colors of film easily and quickly. Now pay attention to the lightning sign in the background. Let's increase the density and the saturation of yellow. See how it looks a lot richer without losing its glow? It still looks like a light, but it's more intense and dense. And here with the center slider, you can change the center of that color, of the color you want to adjust. In this case, yellow. It tells Resolve what area it should see as yellow. Warm, orangey yellow areas or more pale greenish yellow areas. If you click here, you can actually see what areas of the image that slice will affect. And you can also go here and select highlight, and now it will stay. And now if I adjust the center, then see, it changes the area of effect of that slice. It's all yellow, but you can pick different hues of yellow. So that's Color Slice. Just play around with it. Practice, you know, that's the only way to get better at things like this. You just practice. And before you know it, you'll take your color grading to the next level. Now, another thing you should do if you want to take your color grading and your videos to the next level is find good music. And I get my music from Audio, the sponsor of this video. Now, for a film look, you obviously want to find music that sounds retro and vintage, right? So you can use Audio's filters or maybe check playlists like Road Trip, Indie Cinema or Soul. And you can even use AI to find the perfect song. And recently, they've also added another super useful feature. Elements. Now you can download each instrument of a song in a separate file. So if you want to get creative and basically rewrite a song so that it matches your video perfectly, Elements is a must-have. I use it all the time when I need to crank my creativity to 11, you know what I mean? So go check it out. Elements is included in the Pro subscription, and don't forget to use my code and link in the description. And of course, thank you so much, Audio, for supporting my channel. Okay, and now let's take a look at the second awesome new Resolve feature. The Film Look Creator, only available in the studio version, but this tool will make your color grading a whole lot easier and more fun, especially if you're a beginner or a content creator and you don't want to spend a lot of time on color grading. Because, well, look, I love the film look, right? Any film look. It doesn't even have to be a film stock emulation. I also like to get creative and create my own custom film look. But that also means that I use a lot of different effects when I want to achieve a creative film look. And I usually end up with a super complex node tree. But not anymore, because the Film Look Creator combines all those effects into one effect. It's amazing. I love this tool. You can see it, right? How I'm smiling here? Yeah, it's absolutely amazing. And you don't even have to mess around with color space transforms, because it's built in the effect. So just drop the Film Look Creator on a node, and then right away here in Color Space Overrides, you can select the profiles for your footage. In my case, SLOG3 and SGamma3.cine. And boom. And then, if you want to keep it super simple, just pick one of the presets and start playing around with the basic settings here, like exposure, highlights, contrast, white balance. Skin bias is the saturation and tint of the skin tones. So you can go for warm and saturated, or more pale, pinkish, less saturated. And subtractive saturation here is again that same type of saturation as in the color slice panel. It increases or decreases saturation without affecting the luminance and brightness. And I mean, look how many amazing looks I can create literally in seconds. It's crazy. Seriously, literally in seconds. I mean, do I still have to explain why I love this tool so much? No, right? It's an incredible tool if you like the film look. And if you don't like the film look, well, I mean, you're watching the wrong video. But you're still welcome, so just stay, okay? Because there's more. So underneath the color settings are all those effects that before I had to add separately, like halation, grain, and flicker. But let's start at the top. Split toning. Super cool effect. It basically adds color to the highlights and the shadows using an opposing hue angle. So let me set it to the maximum here so that I can show you what it does. Then let me change the hue angle here. This, for example, this is a classic film look. Now it adds yellow to the highlights and blue, the opposite color, to the shadows. But of course, you can pick whatever you want here. Just remember that it's always opposing colors. And with the pivot slider, you can set the point where you want the shadows to end and the highlights to start. So basically, how much of the midtones you want to be part of the highlights or the shadows. You know what I mean? Then we have vignette, which adds a vignette, duh. and then halation, one of my favorites. It makes the highlights glow, and it also adds a color around edges of high contrast areas. Like here, see? It adds a bit of like a red glow around the edge here. And with the hue slider, you can actually pick that color. Then blue makes the highlights glow. It's very subtle, but it looks great. Film grain. Obviously, if you want to create a film look, you're gonna need film grain. I usually just use a preset and then I tweak it a little bit and that's it. Then flicker, in case you want to go super vintage or retro. Oh yeah, and remember that most of these effects are enabled by default, so always check. Gate weave then mimics the horizontal and vertical shift of the image. That's caused by the film being pulled through the camera's gate. It's very technical and it's usually also a subtle effect, but it makes a difference. And it's also very difficult to create manually and very time consuming, but here you can do it in seconds. And then with film gate, you can basically set the projection aspect ratio. And that's it. Now, I don't know about you, but I absolutely love these tools. Color Slice, Film Look Creator, I'm so glad that they've added that. But what do you think? Is this maybe a reason to finally go for DaVinci Resolve Studio, the Film Look Creator? I don't know, I think it's very enticing, no? So let me know in the comments. Anyway, thank you so much for watching and see you in the next one.